Throughout this course on Italian-American culture, we have seen a vast array of Italians as they tried to integrate into the American society. However, integration was not as easy as it seemed, as it carried a different lifestyle with it. Also, integration could be made difficult for these new Italian-Americans. My first movie example comes from the movie Ask the Dusk by Robert Towne. In this movie, we see our main character, Arturo Bandini, as he tries to start his life as a writer in America. In the beginning, we can see how he is well enough integrated into American society that he can do normal things. However, the search for finding the typical American girl is much harder for him. For example, we have a scene where Arturo sees Camilla's car registered under the last name Lombardi in order to get the treatment of a quote-unquote white person. In this, she explains to him that it makes things in her life easier, and it's fun to her. She even asks him why wouldn't he do the same. This movie also seems to draw reference from the article on mentally inferior immigrants, in which they talk about how these Italian Americans breeding with those in the public could hurt the intelligence of the American population. This is because they believed intelligence was purely hereditary, and that it could cause the children of these partial Italian couples to be dumb and not of any benefit to society. Going back to the movie, we also have a scene where we see a librarian sweet-talking to Arturo and acting interested as she tells him that she likes his hands. When hearing this, Arturo is very happy and smiling until she reads his ID and sees that his last name is Bandini. Once seeing this, she says, "You're Italian?" and then reads off the charge he will have for having the book and returning it late as a sign of her new disapproval for him. With a last name like Bandini, it's very clear that he'll never have an easy future as it seems. My second movie example comes from the movie Big Night by Campbell Scott and Stanley Tucci. In this movie, we see a more defining example of how this slow integration into society could not only not work for these Italian Americans, but it could cause trouble with their family ties and those around them. In the movie, it can be seen that Primo isn't opposed to doing things the quote-unquote Italian way, especially with the dishes that he makes at the restaurant. However, Secondo is trying to integrate himself into society a lot better than those around him. For example, in this scene, we can see Secondo talking with this American couple on why spaghetti doesn't actually have meatballs, but yet this is in reference to the risotto that she ordered, as she doesn't understand what authentic Italian risotto would actually look like. Then, Secondo tells Primo, and we see him get very frustrated about these American people not understanding this Italian food. However, Secondo isn't afraid to live up to American lifestyle and try to please others with this American way of life. This is why he offers to make the pasta himself, because changing to this Americanized way of life and doing things only puts the strong Italian family ties in danger, as can be seen up above. This movie also seems to draw reference to an article, which is The Italians of Lower Order. This is because in this article, they talk about how Italians are only beggars who are not of any benefit to society. And although we see how some Italian businesses do work in this movie, we also see how Primo and Secondo run out of money. So it only adds on to this theory that these Italian Americans will always be beggars and how they will not be of any benefit to society. This is very interesting throughout the entirety of this movie. As can be seen above, Secondo is trying to lecture Primo on how he needs to make the pasta, make the pasta, make the pasta. Yet, as can be seen, Primo is very upset because he knows that this is not how pasta is supposed to be made, how it shouldn't just be normal, starch upon starch upon starch. This is why he even mentions how he could add mashed potatoes to it. Then we cut right here to seeing Secondo get very upset and tell Primo, go ahead and talk to the lady. Tell her what your problem is with what she has been doing, and how she says she doesn't like the pasta. But no, Primo doesn't want to talk to her, and this is why, because he knows she won't understand what he's saying. Therefore, he drops it then and there. The last scene of reference from this movie is when we see Secondo spend all of their money on these ingredients for food, yet they're spending the last bit of their money, which means this could be the end of their restaurant. In this, Secondo seems to put his brother, his girlfriend, and everyone else back in Italy off to the side due to his own self-interest, because he knows that if they lose and don't make the money off of this party, then it could be detrimental to the entirety of their business. Overall, as seen in the movies from this course on Italian-American culture, there are plenty of stereotypes and prejudices that keep these Italian-Americans from succeeding in their integration into the American society. This could be the new Americanized way of thinking, or even just your last name. But regardless, there were many barriers to pass in order for these Italian-Americans to integrate into this American society and really live that American dream.